Slayer, 7 Days to Die with Silver Blade.
damn it, son of a... Ouch.
You must remember to...
Hey, Miles Power!
Don't you feel foolish?
Greetings, minion survivalists and fellow gamers. This is Silver Blade playing 7 Days to Die, Alpha 15.1, and this is episode number 82. And I've done some work off camera, namely, took all my coal and nitrate and ginned out all the gunpowder I could, in addition to the stuff that I bought. I've also got the buckshot, paper, bullet casings, and bullet tips to make some more ammo. I want at least 93 more rounds of 7.62s and the rest in gunpowder shells. But right now, excuse me, I usually don't like to burp on camera, but ginger ale will do that to you, and yes, it's not due. So what I'm going to do is try to drop this face of the mountain, at least to start. And I've already done a hole going in that way from way back there. So we'll just see how we do. I figured, you know, the next episode most likely won't be Horde Night. We'll see. So anyways, let's start digging. Alright, we're getting some resources now. Iron, excellent. And we're gonna have to pick some of this up. Oh yeah. Daddy like. There's even more up there, that's just crazy. Alright, we'll just keep going until we find the other side, and hey, there's more nitrate. More iron. This is a nice find. I'm gonna be going all crazy here if I don't keep on the ball. Let's get some sand going. Swap out frames. Thank you for the sand, Mr. Sandman. Actually, let's pick out that. Oh man, I'm gonna want to get into that. And that. This is gonna be a mountain of love. Look at all that goodness. Alright, I can't reach any further, so we're just gonna leave that. Hello. Get all. Ah. Thought that was actually... It was fool's nitrate. And I'm a big fool for getting suckered in by the resources. Again, it's showing what it shouldn't be showing. There we go. This is all coming down anyways, but I'm going to have to look into resource collection here at some point. So we're just going to keep digging until we get to the back end of that tunnel that I dug in, cutting into this. And we'll just drop this. Just, I know it's kind of a filler episode, but it's relaxing. And I know some of you guys have mentioned it from last week's episode. It was relaxing to watch, and I tend to agree. And I'm thinking we'll probably start off next week. Whoops. Start off next week with a Horde Night. At the rate things are going. I shouldn't be whacking at this with a pickaxe. I should be doing it with a shovel. Uh, Let's see how far along we are. Okay, we're almost to the end. Hopefully this won't take too long, because we got some ammo to craft. And I want to do a review of my defenses and make sure everything is ship-shape and bristle fashion, as the saying goes. And I keep digging where it shouldn't be digging, which is why I make sand for filler. So this here, that makes it all worthwhile. Alright, so now we dig up here, widen this up. Just gotta go as high as we can and not step on those spikes. Swing, jump. Swing, jump. Swing. Okay, the timing was off on that, plus the distance. Swing, jump. Okay, we're good. Let me fill in this little patch, because I like things tidy. Don't know about you guys, but I'm kind of obsessive in certain areas of being a neat freak. I do not say it with an ounce of shame. Although, I gotta be honest, as much of a neat freak as I can be, there are times where I am a bit of a slacker. Because sometimes there's just better things to do than obsess, you know? So I always juggle between this whole anal retentive and just way too relaxed than I need to be. It's just one extreme or the other. Just a nice little dose of the chaos that's in my peon brain. And no, I didn't say you can pee on my brain. It's a peon brain. Nothing to do with urine. I don't get into that kinky stuff. I see some nitrate. It keeps giving me nitrate. So when I bring down this mountain, hopefully I'll be able to pick up some of that. Holy Moses. There we go. Yeah. Oh, come on, you're cold. Wussy. Gotta keep it straight. Keep the discipline. There we go. Should be just about done. Whoops. With. Oh yeah. That's what daddy like. Okay, I thought we were almost done, but got a little bamboozled. It is quite hypnotic. The only thing that actually is more hypnotic in a video game for a mundane task like this is mining in Imperion. Back when you had the handheld laser for mining, I could sit and just stare blankly at the screen, drooling like an idiot, and just be so content with it. I mean, I've never been stoned in my life, but I imagine that's kind of what it's like, and just sit there going, it's so pretty. And this is sort of what I imagined it to be like. Right or wrong. So now I do the undercutting. And if we... And let's do this safe and somewhat smart. Let's start off in the back end and work our way across. Oops, dug a little too high. Let's see, okay, we got plenty of inventory space. And we'll patch up holes after this sucker's dry. And just gotta drop the hammer down a little bit more. Oh my, we're almost all the way through, so wait! Pick that out. There we go. There we go. This is going to take a little bit, so I hope you're patient. And if you're not, that just sucks to be you. Patience is a virtue. Honor virtuitus premium. Honor is the reward of virtue. Who says I'm not smart? I know a little Latin. Never took a class in my life. Dink. Oh, I am going to have so much fun coming back through here later on and getting all of the nitrate and other resources back up in there. Oh, yeah. Silver's gonna play. Okay, that made me sound a little too prepubescent. But what else is new? Forty-one years old, and they'll drop eventually. Oh man, I am getting so punchy tonight. This sucker's gonna come down on my head anytime now. Hopefully it's on that side of my head and not that side of my head. Keep it coming. That's not what I wanted to dig. Silly game. There we go. Getting closer to the end, boys and goyles. It is so hypnotic, but it's also pretty darn quick, really, when you consider I don't have to climb up a goddamn hill. Oh boy, here it goes. Backing the hell out. On my feet, because I don't want to miss this. Oh, look at that. Oh, there's some resources that dropped. Excellent. This whole mountainside is going. Maybe if I can run through here a little bit, pick up some of this. Is that some iron right there? Maybe. Yep, there's some iron, some nitrates dropping. Frame rates are dropping. Oh, goodness, yeah. Holy crap. It sounds like if I took one step in there, I would be squish bait. And I am spamming the E key like crazy. Keep going. Pick up the good stuff. I don't want the other stuff. Just the good stuff. Just the good stuff. Come on. It's still dropping. Come on. Spamming the E key. Spamming the E key. Oh, no. Get into it. Don't get into it. I'd love to look up and watch this whole thing fall, but there's good stuff coming out of it. Ah, hell. There we go. When you hear that, you know, kind of... It's not sand falling. You hear it. You know that there's resources in there. Come on. Pick it up. Pick it all up. Drop that love on top of me. Not literally on top of me. It's still coming. Well, crap. I probably should have done a smaller section. Come on. Give me the goodness. Give me the goodness. Oh shit, this is gonna hurt. This is gonna hurt. Or maybe not. Well, there's still some that can fall yet. Alright. There is the evening sound. How I'm not getting hurt, I don't know, but maybe it's because I'm just that damn lucky. Or that damn skill, you guys decide. I'd wait till the end, but a lot of this is gonna despawn before then. This is taking a while. Ooh, that's gonna hurt. Oh, oh, oh. Chocolate rain! Come on, give me more of the nitrate. Give me some iron. That's it. Party's over, man. Time to go home and sober up. And just like that, a whole freaking mountain's face been ripped right off. And I'm not gathering any more resources. But that was freaking cool. So let's annihilate this. Come to me, my pretties. Come on, get my inventory. Get in there. Get in there. That's right. I don't need you, but I want you. Okay, this will probably have to be dug out and then refilled. And maybe even balanced out. We'll see. Yeah, this is gonna have to be dug out. So, not too bad. Not too bad. Alright, let's see what we got here. 460 nitrate, oil shale, raw iron. I'll take it. Without complaint. Oh, let's see. Pitch that for the moment. Now, let's see if there's any uneven spots here, like where I had to replace stuff. And it doesn't look like it. Alright, let's get a better perspective on this, shall we? And let's check it up close first. Okay, so we widened it out, definitely exposed some resources. Ta-da! Ta-da! Ta-da, 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 ta-da. It's widening out, so now there's less chance of them just going down steps. They're going to go kersplat if they go over the ledge there. It'll also eliminate the chances, mostly eliminate the chances, of them spawning up on the walls. If anything, they'll spawn on that wall and go splat, but they may still spawn up in here. You know, if they come up over the top, there's a greater chance now that they're just going to go all the way down. So we are basically working the game against itself to force my will, and that will is to make the base function by my means because they're necessary. So yeah. And it's also, I measured it out, I think it's about the same width as over here. Let's see, 3 from the wall. I think this is 4 from the wall. 1, 2, 3. Okay, so it's 6 from the wall. A little bit more than I anticipated, but you know what? I don't care. It doesn't have to be absolutely perfect. It has to work. I can do perfection on it later. I'd have to come in like along here to just to level it out. No big deal. Go figure. First time I'd done that in a while. Second time I've done it in a while. And we'll just drop frames in here because I'm feeling extra twitchy. Twitch, twitch. That's enough for now. I need to go get this leg patched up and get to the next phase of something important. And let's make some ammo. So leg first, ammo second. Okay, we'll get rid of the sand and the stone. Okay, I don't have any more room for stone. So you know what that means? Oop, wasteful. Damn it, wrong box. Wrong box. That's better. Okay, we got wasteful. I'm making more sand, ain't I? Cut that out. Wasteful. All right. So let's. And let's do that and that. As you can see, I made 300 forged steel from all that iron from previously. Yeah, that's going good. So now let's make some bullets. 93, if we can afford it. Oh yeah. 93.762 rounds coming up. 47 shotgun slugs. Rocking it. Okay, with one bit of gunpowder left over. Fine by me, we'll have plenty. So we'll sit here and stew for a minute. Oh, I'm hot now when I was just freezing not too long ago. Peachy. Stretch time. Stretch. Okay. So far, we've done so good. So this is going to take a little bit. I'm not going to be worrying about the weapon skill increases from that. Yeah, this is what we need to do. Need to refurbish my shovel. I think it's 20. Yep. So get that in the queue. Put the wood away. I'm not gonna do any more digging, so I'll put the iron shovel away. And yeah. Swig of the dew, so you know, Fat Carl, chug. That one's in honor of Midnight Designer for kicking off that trend. You can thank him or blame him, either way you want to go about it. So here's the deal, guys. We're in the home stretch for Day 42 Horde. I think we'll have some action, you know, stuff to do before, but it may carry over to where the Horde night will have to be on Monday, or if in the next hour I get feeling extra generous, I might make an extra episode and do a specific episode of the Horde night as an extra episode here on Friday of this week. I haven't quite settled in on an answer on that one, so pay attention to my subscription thing when video comes out, whether it's on Twitter or Minds or Patreon or YouTube. If I do an extra episode, you'll see it at 9 p.m. Friday. If I don't, then you'll see it at 8 p.m. or 8 a.m. rather. 8 a.m., 9 a.m., whatever. 9 a.m. Friday Eastern Time or 8 a.m. Monday Eastern Time. I am losing my damn mind. Okay, so we're going to get this shovel done. We're going to get this ammo packed away. Actually, now that I think about it, I probably will do the Horde night on Monday. Because it's kind of late here right now. And I want to have my full faculties for the Horde night. So I'll do an episode tomorrow. And hopefully be able to do Horde night on Monday. So that settles that. So once we get this shovel done, we'll call it an episode. Sorry that it wasn't exactly, you know, splody heads, because I've been missing the splody heads. I really have. But, you know, when you're playing this game, or watching it, you know, games like this, you know, you have to kind of keep your priorities in order. You have to look ahead, plan things out, you know, it's like, alright, things are going to change, so you have to plan to adapt to whatever changes come your way. And in this case, I figured, well, I need to get that clip face out of the way. It was a good time. I didn't have anything else to do, and I'm a busybody. So the best thing for me to do was, well, get it done, get it out of the way, so that I will be even better prepared for Horde Night. And as you can see, I now am, at least where this is concerned. And we get some resources out of it, so that was a bonus. But yeah, this whole thing, that's going to make things a lot easier to deal with. Now, I think the thing that's going to really complicate me are these clips right in here, right back in there. I'm not supremely worried about it, but they, you know, zombies will get hung up on it. I mean, that's almost guaranteed. But as long as they're not hung up over the base area, I'd still rather that they come in through there so I can do the whole zombie shoot thing like the original function and plan of this base was. But, like I said, you gotta adapt, change things up, you know. It's just the only way you can do it when it comes to survival, and that's what this game is about, survival. You gotta be able to be flexible and change with the things, because not everything's gonna fit your plans, but you can change things to, you know, bend things to try to work with your plan. Something like that. So anyways, I babble enough. Thank you guys so much for watching. Do check out the links in the description box below. A lot of the people that are featured there are friends of mine or people that I think really need to get some attention, get some eyeballs on their channel, and you know, be uplifting to them, help them out, you know, welcome them to the community as you are welcome to the community. Be nice, help them out, they'll help you out. And those that are experienced, that are in the list, you know, they're great people to watch and learn from. Some of the greats that are listed there, Midnight Designer, Games for Kicks, you know, two of a handful of YouTubers that I really look up to and got me into this game. And I hope that they will provide a similar benefit to you as they have to me. And do check them out. Subscribe to them. Tell them Silverblade sent you. Anyways, guys, that is enough from me. Thank you so much for watching. And until next time, which is tomorrow at 8 a.m. See you later. Twitch.